Hello everybody, thanks for joining me today. I'm Jackie and I create mosaics using sea glass. And today I'm going to show you how I'm going to finish off this piece, which is going across on the ferry to Prince Edward Island. So I just wanted to take a second to say thank you to everybody for watching my videos and subscribing to my channel. If you haven't subscribed, be sure to do so. And I just wanted to let you know how much it means to me that people are watching my videos and making nice comments and sharing the videos. All of this sort of gives me a bit of feedback because I love to do sea glass mosaic art and I'm really enjoying sharing it through the YouTube videos. But it's nice to know that people are actually watching it and actually enjoying the videos. So thank you very much for that. So today what I'm going to talk to you about, if you saw my last video, I showed you how I had taken my design and inspiration ideas and created this sea glass mosaic, which is going across on the ferry to Prince Edward Island. And today I'm going to talk to you a little bit more about the design elements for filling in the white in the railing and filling in the sky. And if you remember from my last video, you would know that going across to the ferry, going across on the ferry to Prince Edward Island is a sister piece to this piece, which is going across on the bridge to Prince Edward Island. So what I'm going to do in my design in the sky, I want to make my design kind of in a similar way as I made this sky. Sometimes I have a few different approaches that I use in making my skies. But where these two pieces are the same size, they're on the same subject matter, because when the ferry stopped running, the bridge opened, so they're related to each other. And so they're kind of meant to hang together too, because it's the life of traveling when we travel by the ferry versus the life of traveling when we travel by the bridge. So I really want the skies to look kind of similar and have some flowing lines in them. So I'm going to keep that in mind when I'm working on this sky piece. So let's get started and I'll show you some of that. So in order to do the sky for my going across on the ferry piece, I want to take a really close look at my sky for the bridge piece. And a few things you'll notice here, I put a heron up in the sky here, but in my bridge piece, or in my ferry piece rather, I want to put seagulls, because nowadays it seems like we'll often see herons, but when I was growing up, we hardly ever saw herons, we would just mostly see seagulls. So I'm going to put some seagulls up in the sky, I think over on this side. And the other thing, you'll see I have all these. What I have here, I have a sun, so I went to my collection of bottle bottoms and I found a similar sized bottle bottom in white, and so I'm going to use that for the sky and put it approximately in the same place. And then I have all these flowing lines coming out from the sun, like the rays of the sun, and then, you know, there's some aqua ones where it has this long flowing line. So I'm just going to do kind of a similar type of sky in my going across on the ferry piece. So here we go. I have a board here covered with white sea glass, and I also have a bunch of aqua sea glass there because I'm going to need that. And I have my white bottle bottom, so I'm going to put that right about there. And I also dug out some blue ones, and I'm of different sizes. So I'm thinking I'm going to have about three seagulls flying through the sky over here. So now I'm going to start making some rays coming out from the sun. And this is where I'll often dig through my tray of my board here covered with white sea glass and just find pieces that kind of go together. And I know that I want to have a couple of rays coming out that are aqua in color. So I want to pick out a bunch of those pieces as well. And this is where you play around with your sea glass quite a bit and really work to make an interesting sky. So I'm working my way across the sky here, and I've been putting in some lines of nice aqua here, and I'll add a few more as I go. Sometimes I've started a bit over on this end as well. Just filling in my sky and making nice wavy lines with my sea glass. So I'm really thrilled with how this is coming together. I really like the flowing lines that I have going in the sky here. And to me, it's worth the extra time to find just the right pieces so that they can kind of go together like in a flowing line like that. Just adds so much more interest into the sky, and it makes it so much more dynamic. So my approach with filling in the railing down here is a little bit different. All I'm doing here is basically filling in as I go. I'm not making any effort to get the pieces lined up to create any sort of secondary pattern. I just want to fill it in because I want it to read fairly solid. I'm not really too concerned about it reading like dynamic sky or flowing wind or anything like that, like I am up here, or rays of the sun. All of those things I had in mind as I was doing the sky. Whereas the railing, it's just filling it in as I go. One of the things that you might find when you're working with white sea glass is that not very many pieces of white sea glass are actually pure white. The number of different colors, you can really notice it up here in the sky. I feel like I'm getting a fair amount of like this seafoam green and all different shades of white. And that's probably influenced by how long it's been in the water, what bottle it came from originally. I find seeing all those different shades of white just adds to the interest of your piece. So there you have it. I finished my going across to PEI on the Ferry piece, and I am fairly pleased with how it turned out in the end. So thanks for joining me today. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to post them. And until next time, happy sea glass hunting.